It is not something that you as a reader reads. It's a journey on which we both are together. So I am with every reader of the book in that moment, traveling and walking together.
Pranam Shri Anishji, it's so wonderful to be with you today. I mean, I took this journey from Gurgaon to just be with you. Shri Anishji is a spiritual master. He's actually a leadership mentor as well and a fellow traveler. And very recently, he's launched a book which is very, very interesting. It's called Let the Mud Settle. I'm going to be in conversation with Shri Anishji today in discussing this book. And the title is so interesting. So let's begin with that. What does the title really mean? Let the mud settle.
So you see, I've been meeting a lot of people, all strata of society. And every person, when I look deep into the person, there's something which is unsettled. And it's my experience that unless all the mud in our being is totally settled, we cannot see the reality. For us to see the reality, for us to see the truth, for us to see the nature of things as they are, the mud really needs to be settled.
That's absolutely wonderful, actually. Yeah, really.
So that's how I think I didn't choose the title. It just came to me based on the experience of meeting so many people.
Yeah. So I'm sure you've kind of gone through a journey which kind of made you realize that the mud needs to settle before you actually move ahead.
Right.
So can you tell us what really inspired you in writing this book?
I think when my own mud started to get settled, that's what kind of inspired me to write about it. But if you see, you know, for any author, a book is an expression.
Absolutely.
It's also a journey.
Absolutely.
It's a way to share your realizations with the fellow beings. It also becomes an offering to all the higher masters from whom you've understood or you've learned this secret of settling the mud. So I would say it's an offering to the higher masters and it's an expression and sharing for the fellow beings. And that's what inspired me to share these, you know, small little seeds of realizations with the fellow travelers. Yeah.
So I'm sure, you know, I'm sure the audience is also expecting some hidden gems in the book.
Right.
You could probably tell us, how can the book really benefit us, you know, because in times like this, you know, that all of us are going through a lot of unsettled times, traumas, and if a book like this comes our way, we'd like to know how it can really benefit us and kind of going through it. Yeah.
Sinupur, I'm not a great reader myself. It's not that I've read a lot, but whatever little I've read, of the ancient shastras, of the new age wisdom, of the Western spirituality, whatever little I've read, I realized that somehow it kind of lacks certain, I would say, either a direction, clarity, or probably the simplicity of it. We've made life and spirituality way too complex.
Okay.
So the thought was to make it very, very easy, simple. And I think for a reader, that's what could be really a game changer. The way the book will lead the reader from, you know, simple things about life to the highest truth of life in a very conversational manner. Then I've also realized that reading alone won't do much. So at the end of every chapter, I've put in a small exercise or something to do so that whatever I have read in a chapter, can I experiment it in my real life? Is it just the theoretical jnana? Or can it be implemented in my life?
Oh, that's so wonderful.
And I think that's something which I always wanted for anything that I read. And I think I made it categorically that every chapter should have some takeaways and something that you do as an experiment and see if it works for you.
I'm sure that really benefit actually, because once you kind of gone through the book and you practice it upon yourself, you'll know which part to take and where is that you're going wrong.
Correct.
I think that's absolutely brilliant.
The other interesting thing, Nupur, I must tell you, when I was writing the book, I didn't really look at, you know, how many chapters should be there or the numbers behind it, etc. But when the book was complete and I kind of looked at all the chapters, there were 18 chapters.
Wow.
And that's when I realized that, you know, Gita also has 18 adhyayas.
Oh, nice.
So of course, you know, it is not a grand scripture of life like Gita, but it was some kind of a coincidence.
Yeah, but that's a lovely coincidence to have, actually. It kind of feels blessing. It's like a blessing that you get, right?
Yeah.
That's wonderful.
And if you look at the index of the chapters, every aspect of human life is covered in that.
Right.
From the relationship to the career to how do you take care of your body to the highest truth possible for a human being. So all of that is kind of packed into just these 250 odd pages.
How nice. So I'm going to in fact read the book myself. I've read parts of it, and one of the things that I had read which was really interesting was when you talked about that when you go into water, any kind of water, with if it's a river or any sort of an ocean, how water can be so healing and magical things can happen to you when you're in water. So I think it's very interesting. I know little things that you've written about which kind of touch your daily lives. You've kind of covered all of that, you know, in the book. Correct. Would you like to read something to us? I mean, from the book, sure. Would be nice.
I think more than the inside of the book, I would like to read few bits from the preface so that we set the tone. So it starts, the preface starts like, it says, this is not a book, but an inner journey on which we are traveling together. Okay. So that's the main intent. It is not something that you as a reader reads. Mm-hmm. It's a journey on which we both are together.
Okay.
So I am with every reader of the book in that moment, traveling and walking together. So that's where it starts. And then it says, and it is not an arduous journey where you walk barefoot, covered with cuts and bruises, or pass through dense forest of fear and loneliness, because that is how many of us look at spirituality.
Right.
You know, lonely journey, lots of pains, lots of doubts, and so on and so forth. But I'm saying, rather, this is a beautiful path, simple, even, straight, and in reach of everyone, where we walk together, exploring the beauty of nature all around. So again, the essence is, it's a journey which is in the reach of everybody.
Right.
It's not for the selected few.
Correct.
And when we walk together, we enjoy the beauty of nature all around us. That's important. So it's not the journey or the destination, it's also the beauty that you see on the way.
Correct.
And I think that's what this book is all about.
It's absolutely wonderful. I think all of us need to set out on this journey that Sri Anish has been. And through his book, I'm sure you'll learn a lot. Thank you so much for being in conversation with me. Thank you so much, Sri Anish. Pranam.
Thank you. Pranam.